One of the defining properties of minerals is their beautiful geometric crystalline form. Crystalline means that the atoms and molecules are arranged in an orderly, long-distance geometric pattern. The organization is established by the formation of chemical bonds as the solid forms. Cleavage is a property of breakage, and its recognition, when used in combination with other characteristics, helps us to identify a mineral by name. Here are some examples. Here's a mineral that exhibits only one cleavage, and judging by the mirror-like reflection of light, this cleavage is termed perfect. Perfect cleavage reflects light off a microscopically smooth, flat surface that's been broken through the mineral. Notice that as the specimen is turned to the light, the reflection appears to flash brightly only at one particular angle. The flash of light on two different sides of the mineral demonstrates that this sample exhibits two different cleavage directions. However, the third direction of the block, at an angle to the first two, is not at all flat and reflective, so there's no cleavage in this direction. This mineral exhibits three cleavage surfaces. The three planes are exposed when the mineral is mechanically broken. The broken crystal form reflects the internal geometric arrangement of atoms and molecules that are invisible to our naked eye observation. At first glance, this blocky specimen seems to show three cleavage directions. After all, it's got three sides. But are those sides the cleavage surfaces from breakage? We see that the surfaces don't reflect light with a flash as the crystal is turned against the light. Instead, the surface of a side is really rough and irregular. It's not flat as a cleavage surface. The sample, in fact, is broken across many small crystals, all at different angles. And so the block-like form of the sample is superficially misleading. This sample is not a single large crystal that's broken along cleavage directions. Rather, it's a rock made of many small crystals, and the reflection from each small crystal appears rough, not flat. The mineral of this sample does not exhibit cleavage. A second property we should note is the angle between any two cleavage directions. For example, this mineral exhibits an approximate right angle, or about 90 degrees, between two cleavage planes. This mineral exhibits an angle that's not a right angle. We'll simplify our observations of cleavage angle by simply noting whether such an angle is approximately at 90 degrees or not. In macroscopic crystals that have been subjected to mechanical stress, sometimes cleavage planes may be visible without being exposed on an outside surface. Here's a close-up of a sample that shows several internal fractures. Note that the internal fractures appear to be planar or flat. So we may presume that this represents directions of cleavage. If the crystal breaks, it'll likely break into multiple pieces along these existing fractures, and then each piece will exhibit one exposed flat surface. So look inside large crystals for straight lines that represent internal fractures, and this evidence will help you to identify the presence of cleavage planes and the angles between them.